First, let's create a composite again. Open the Options, Element Attributes, Composites dialog. Select concrete floor insulated with 10mm tile from the list. Click Duplicate. Enter a new name, concrete floor insulated with 10mm tile on ground, and click OK. Change the thickness of the concrete skin to 0.06. Remove the bottom plaster gypsum skin. Please make sure that the new composite structure is enabled for slabs at the Use With panel of the dialog. Click OK to proceed. Now we can create the slab. The walls define the size and shape of the slab. Activate the slab tool in the toolbox. Open the slab settings from the info box. Display the geometry and positioning page of the slab settings dialog. Select the composite structure option. Select the previously created concrete floor insulated 10mm tile on ground from the list. Set the reference plane location to top. Display the model panel of the dialog. Activate the top override surface option. Select the wood, pine-grained horizontal surface from the list. Overriding surfaces is advantageous if we have the same structure with different appearance, for example, walls with different paints. In this case, it's not necessary to recreate the composite with different building materials. We can override the default surface. Display the Categories and Properties panel of the dialog. Select Load-Bearing Element for Structural Function, Exterior for Position, and Slab for Element Classification. By default, slabs have floor as the predefined type attribute, which is appropriate for us now. Please make sure that the structural bearing layer is selected. Click OK to apply all changes. Select the rectangular geometry method in the info box. Hold the space bar and move the cursor towards the bottom on the exterior side of the walls. This activates the magic wand feature that can recognize closed contours. Click when the plane indicator turns into a darker gray close to the bottom of the wall, and the slab will immediately be created in the middle and at a correct elevation. Naturally, slabs can always be placed on the floor plan view. We model the sidewalk area on the floor plan with the slab tool as well. Let's assume that the correct skin settings are not available in the current project, but that we have used the right composite in another project before. In this case, we can import existing composites from other files. Let's see an example and add a composite from an existing project. Open Options, Element Attributes, Attribute Manager. In this dialog on the left side, you can review all attribute-like properties in one place, like layers, materials, composites, etc. The check mark next to the attribute indicates if it's currently in use in the project. On the right side, you can open the attribute set of another project, browse, and add additional attributes to the current project. Open the Composites tab page of the dialog. Click the Open button and browse for the existing project PLN file. Click Open and notice that the composites used by this plan file appear on the right side. Select Exterior Pavement from the list on the right side. Uncheck the All Associated Attributes checkbox so only the composite will be created, but fills and surfaces linked to it will not be duplicated. Click Append. Notice that the exterior pavement composite is now available in the list on the left side as well. Click OK to proceed. Click Create at the Confirm Changes dialog. Switch to the project map of the pop-up navigator and double-click to open the ground floor or click the Zero Ground Floor tab at the tab bar. Double-click the Slab tool to open its Settings dialog. Display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Set the ground floor as home story. Enter minus 0.05 for offset to home story value. Make sure that composite is selected for the structure. Choose the exterior pavement as the cut composite fill. Set the reference plane location to top. Display the model panel. Override the top and side materials of the slab. Choose pavement, brick moss for both top and side override surfaces. Display the categories and properties panel of the dialog. Select non-load-bearing element for structural function. Exterior for position. And site geometry for element classification. Select the site and landscape terrain layer. Click OK to apply all changes and leave the dialog. Select the polygonal slab geometry method in the info box. Zoom into the plan. Click the line work intersection points to define the exterior pavement as presented on the screen. Open the 3D window to see the result. Now we need to create an opening in the pavement slab, defined by the footprint of the exterior walls. Select the pavement slab, and make sure that the slab tool is selected in the toolbox. Click on any edge of the selected pavement slab to display the PET palette. This palette contains all editing commands available for the selected element. Select the Subtract from Polygon option from the PET palette. Click on the top outer corners of the exterior walls. Note that even though you pick a point on top of the wall, its projected correspondent is created on the level of the slab automatically. Once you click the last point, an opening is created in the pavement slab. Press Escape once to deselect the pavement slab.